Hello everyone. In today's video, I'm going to tell you function. It's not that you are not familiar with this function. You have already used the functions and they were the built-in functions, right? So now, this is advised and this is the good programming practice not to write the larger program, okay? So a larger program is broken into smaller units, right? It is having a various advantages, okay? So let's see what this function is. The larger program when broken into smaller units, and that smaller units are called the functions, okay? So now let's see what this function is actually, okay? So a function wraps set of program statement into single unit. A function wraps set of program statements, set of program statement into single unit, into single unit, and gives it a name, and gives it a name. This unit can then be invoked or called from other part of the program. Now, each and every word, each and every line, we will see that what it is, how the function wraps set of statements in a single unit, how it makes a bundle of statements, and how the names are given to that bundle, and how it is called in the other, from the other part of the program. Okay, so now let's see some more features of using functions. Okay, so now the first one is it reduces program size. Okay, it reduces program size. Function code is stored in only one place in the memory. It is stored in one place in the memory. How it reduces size? Come to the second point. Any sequence of instructions appeared in a program more than once is a candidate for being made function. Okay? Is a candidate for being made function. How you will decide that the which set of statement from the program should be created as a function? So what are the statements, when you, how you will realize that this set of statements should be made as function? So once again I am reading this point. Any sequence of instructions appeared in a program more than once. Okay, any sequence of instructions appeared in the program more than once. Or another way you can say, when a same set of statements are, you will find that it is being repeated in the program, okay, that statement is a candidate for being made function. Okay, one thing I'll give you example to explain this point. You have used iterative construct, looping construct, okay, like for loop, while loop. What, when you realize that you should use for loop or you should use while loop, when you found the same set of statement required to be executed again and again sequentially, okay, so you realize that instead of writing the same statement again and again, why not, it should be put inside the loop, and we will mention the number of iteration, number of repetition, means how many times the statement will be executed. So the loop is very well clear to you. So to understand this part, you may take the example of loop. But the difference is there that loop executes the statements sequentially. But functions, the advantage of function is what? It can be called in the different part of the program, okay? It can be called sequentially or it can be called from the different parts of the program, okay? So this point is very clear. Any sequence of instructions appeared in the program more than once is a candidate for being made function. Okay, so if a set of statements are written once in the function, so definitely it reduces size. Okay, now come to the second point. It reduces code redundancy. Redundancy means repetition. Okay, or it also provides the reusability feature. Clear? Redundancy means repetition. Okay, reduces code redundancy. Again, you can refer the second point. Okay, when the sequence of instructions appeared in the program or written in program again and again, so it is being written once. Okay, when you will use function, so it is required to write once, so it reduces redundancy, repetition. Okay, now come to the next point. Code maintenance becomes easy because of function. How this code maintenance becomes easy? One thing, students, once the software is developed, the maintenance process is that process which is being there till the software exists. Clear? So what is included in maintenance? Maintenance includes whenever, according to time, we need to add some new features to the program or the software. According to time, we need to remove some of the features from the software. Okay, so here is code maintenance becomes easy because of functions. So how it is? Adding of new feature to a function will be easy, or deletion of any statements or the any feature from the function is easy, because you don't have to disturb any other functions. Whichever function you have to change, or the function you have to add the feature, you just have to change or modify that function, so other function will not be reflected. Okay, now come to the last point. Code debugging easy. As you know very well, that when the programming written, or when the program codes are written, it requires to be executed. Once it is being executed, and during the execution, some of the error comes. So that error, what you are doing, you are again coming to the program, and you comes to the program, then you are finding the error, in which line the error is there. So you are correcting that error, then again you are reinterpreting or recompiling the program, and once system finds no error, no discrepancy in the statements, then it produces the result. Okay, so this process is called debugging. So obviously, when a function is already existing, and that function is definitely will be debugged, will be compiled, and will be the error free. Okay, so when you will add new feature to that function, so definitely that function will be required to again re-execute to see that whether that function is having any error or not. Okay, so that code debugging easy. Okay, so that makes code debugging easy. No need to go to the other function, only the error containing function modified without disturbing other functions. Okay, so now students, these are very important points regarding function. Okay, these are very important points regarding the functions. Now come to the another part. Now this it is very clear to you what the function is, what are the advantages of the function. Okay, now one thing I want to mention to you, I would like to mention to you, that is sometime this function is also mentioned as method. Recall function and method. Clear? As I would like to give you some examples that already you have used the built-in functions like print, like input, like converting the string value into the integer by using the int function or eval function. So various functions you have used. Clear? And methods also you have used in list and in dictionaries. Clear? To manipulate the list and to manipulate the dictionary. You, if you have not remembered, then refer again to the dictionary and list. Okay? Now, what this function is, let's see what is the difference between where we are calling this function as function and where we are calling this function as method. Clear? So just see that, look here, function. Okay, functions are defined. It is defined. It is defined individually. Individually in the Python program. Function is defined individually in the Python program. Okay? And then it is called by its name. And then function is called by its name. Example, you have already used function like input and parenthesis, very well known to you. You are very well remembered and used that the all the functions names are following the parenthesis. Okay, this is the identification of the function. So function name and the followed with the parenthesis. So this is the input is the built-in function, means already created function which you have used. And print is also inbuilt function which you have very frequently used. So what happened, you are just using the name of the function and parenthesis freely in the program. Clear? So now just see what is this method. When this function will be called as method? When a function is defined inside the class. When a function is defined inside a class, it is called method. When a function is defined inside a class, it is called a method, right? And methods are called in following two ways. It is called or invoked in following two ways. In following ways. First way is name of the object, or you can say that object name dot method name parenthesis. Another way is what? Class name dot method name parenthesis. Don't confuse. When we are creating, as you don't have right now the depth knowledge of the concept of the class, so just you know, class is the section which contains set of functions and variables. Clear? Set of functions, when a collection of functions placed inside another unit, that unit is called a class. Set of functions placed, set of functions and variables which is used by the functions placed in another unit, that that unit is called a class. Okay, so sometime it is used directly by writing the name of the class dot method name, or that class objects are created, so object name dot method name. Okay, clear? Now let us see that how many types of these functions are. Okay, so this is well clear to you. Now let us see the different, how many ways the functions are existing, or you can say the different types of functions. Okay, first one, module. I'll tell you module later on. Okay, then built in function and module, built-in function and user defined function. Once again I want to I would like to come to the previous part, that is function and module. How you are differentiating function and module? The placement of the function and the method of calling the function. Okay, the way function is called, how function and or method is different. Okay, actually they are same, function and methods are same, but where they differs, the placement of the function. Okay, if function is outside the class, means if function is in the Python program, okay, and they are called by using the directly name of the function, they are the function. Okay, and when the same function is placed inside the class, so they will be called as a method, and they are not called just by writing the name. They must be qualified with the member of the name of the class of which that function is member. Okay, so the class name or the object name is qualifying the function name. Okay, so now don't confuse that I am writing here the different. So the built-in functions are also there, built-in methods are also there, user-defined function. If user-defined functions are there, then user-defined methods will also be there. If built-in functions are there, so built-in methods are also there. Okay, so module we will discuss later on. First of all, I'd like to tell you about the built-in function. That built-in functions you have used many, like previously also I've given example. Print is built-in function and input is also built-in function. Okay, and various built-in function you have used. Built-in functions don't require any name to be qualified. If built-in method will be there, the built-in method must be qualified with its name. Just like if you use the update, so dictionary dot, if you use update method of the dictionary, so you must have to write dictionary, name of the dictionary dot update method. Clear? Now come to the very what the topic we are discussing here, that is a user defined function. Now you will come to know that how these built-in functions are created. There is no different way. Okay, as the built-in functions are created, same way you will create the user-defined functions. Now you will come to know that how these built-in functions will be created by the developers. Okay, so to know the built-in what is, how to create the user-defined function, there is two part. When you will go to define a function, you have to be familiar with the two part. Okay, one is the, first of all you have to define a function, that is the function definition, okay, which contains the code, which contains set of statement, set of statements, okay, or you can also mention here that wraps the set of statements. Okay, And the another one is the define function definition does nothing till it is not called. Okay, so to invoke the statements written inside the function, you must have to place a function call statement. So function call, function call, this is very this is too important part for the function. Function must be defined first, and then function, if you would like to execute the function, you must have to place a function call. Okay, so let's see the example of how you can define a function, how you can call a function by writing the syntax of the function or seeing the example. Now write down syntax to define a function. Syntax for function definition. Okay, syntax for function definition, def, and the function name or the name of the function, function name, that is the identifier that what you have learned in the tokens of the programming program. You remember that you have learned identifier. Okay, so identifier is the variable names, functions names, function names, class names, they are the identifiers. So you will write def function name parenthesis begin and list of parameters, list of parameters or list of arguments. Okay, list of parameters or list of arguments, and then colon. Okay, otherwise you write like this. Def, as you know that Python is case sensitive language, so you have to write in small. Then function name or list of parameters, like you can also write like parameter 1, okay, comma parameter 2, comma parameter 3, comma and number of parameters, parameter n, okay, and colon. Now here set of statement, like statement 1, statement 2 and statement n. Remember that this will be indented. Okay, or you can also say that set of statements. Okay, or you can also mention the set of statement as function body. Okay, function body, clear? Now we will see the example of this function definition. Now how you will call a function, clear? Now students, once again after giving you one definition of one example of function definition and function call, I'll again come to the syntax of the function definition. Okay, now syntax for function call, syntax for function call. Okay, so function name parenthesis begin and parameters value, parameters value. Okay, now let's see one example of how we can define a function and how we can call a function, what function definition does, what a function call does. Okay, let's see one example. start a program. Just I'm going to write a program which will accept two numbers for addition. Okay, so you'll write def name of the function is sum parenthesis begin a comma b colon. This shows that some more part of this function definition is having here, and you'll write c equals to a plus b, and then print c. Okay, this is the function definition. Now come to the program. X equals to, you can directly also pass the values. Okay, let us pass the values directly. Y equals to sum 20 comma 30. Okay, and print y. Right, sorry, no need to write this one, just you have to call the function, because this function is not returning any value, so you don't have to write this one. We will come for the return value from the function. That example we will also see. Now see, def sum a and b is the parameter. Okay, that is the value which will be received by the function, right? C equals to a plus b, so a and b is will hold the value which will be called, which will be sent by, or which will be passed through the function call statement. Okay, now this is what, this is function call statement. Okay, and this is the function definition. Clear? So whenever this function will be called from any part of the program, then what will happen? Whenever this statement will be found out by the interpreter or the compiler, the control will jump to the place where the function is defined. Okay, so what happened, this sum will carry this first value and the second value. These are the parameters or arguments. So sum will pass these two numbers to the function definition, and it will search that where this function is defined. So function is defined here, so play control from here, control will jump to the function definition. From here, for control will jump to the function definition, and the A will accept 20 and B will receive 30. So A and B is having value, A is holding 20 and B is holding 30. Okay, and 20 plus 30, C will hold here, C will hold 50. Clear? And print statement will print the 50. Okay, so what output will come? Output will be 50. Okay, so this is one example of function definition and how function is called. So same program we will write in next session. The same different form of the function definition we will see in next session. Okay, thank you.